The Yida refugee camp is overwhelmed. There were 17,000 people in March, and there are now over 55,000. In the face of such a huge emergency, MSF has increased its hospital bed capacity and quadrupled the number of international staff.
When I arrived to the camp in June, we had these three tents here, and that was the entire hospital. Now we are operating a hospital of 80-plus beds with 14 tents. So we've grown quite a bit in the last 2.5 months.
Every week, MSF treats over 3,000 patients who are either hospitalized or receiving outpatient care. The situation has improved, and the mortality rate has dropped to 2%. The most common victims are children under the age of 5, as it is they who are the most vulnerable. More than half the children suffering from malnutrition have to be hospitalized.
We are seeing a lot of children here who have concomitant medical problems along with their malnutrition, which makes the problem even larger. So cases of children coming in under 5 years old with upper respiratory tract infections, conjunctivitis, and a lot of acute watery diarrhea make it very difficult for these young children, these infants, to gain weight and keep that weight on.
Ongoing vigilance is called for to improve living conditions. MSF is working with other organizations to improve the water supply, sanitation, and hygiene in the camp. MSF is now supplying 80,000 liters of clean, chlorinated water a day and is building public latrines.
Ill diseases are caused by hygiene almost always, basically because of so many people living in this small area and not having access to clean water, not having access to soap.
1,000 new arrivals settle in the camp every week. MSF has managed to reduce the mortality rate, but it cannot afford to let up, because the population in Yida is still living in very poor conditions.